Probably have a few days here next to you.
Okay.
With your family.
Okay, I have a question for you guys this morning. I want to know what you guys think the word change means. What do you think, Noah?
It means that, like, there's something one way and then you change it to a different way.
That's right. When something's one way and then maybe it changes to another way. Can you think of things that change? Are there things that change during the days? Nice and loud, Ryan. Your clothes change every day. Absolutely. Cassie? Caterpillars change. Yes, they do. What else changes?
The sky.
The sky changes. What's changing outside right now? What's changing right now?
Leaves.
The leaves are changing right now. That's right. Okay, he's got something too. And the seasons change, and that's exactly where I need to change. Because you know what? Seasons in people's lives change too. Not just the seasons outside. You want to say something,
Chloe?
That's right, the world changes. That's right. You got one more thing? listen to this verse.
It's found in Hebrews chapter 13, page number 13 and little number 8. So 13:8, and it says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever.
So even though this gift isn't going to be leading you all the time, will Jesus change? No. May I have that book right there, Mr. Bruce? Will this best book ever change? No. Will Miss Kit hold this book near and dear because you guys gave it to me? Yes. And will Miss Kit still be in the hall for hugs? Yes. And will Miss Kit still come watch softball and baseball and volleyball and piano recitals and dance recitals? Yes. Because I love you. Okay? And don't you ever, ever forget that. But what I'd ask you guys to do is pray with me while we pray that God will bring us someone wonderful, 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 wonderful to help lead you. Can you pray with me? Let's pray. Dear Jesus, I thank you for these children. And I thank you for what they have meant to me and to my life and for their older brothers and sisters that I've had the opportunity to love on as well. And I just ask that you will continue to bless them, Lord, and that I know you're preparing someone to fill this place in your church to serve your children and to lead them. And I thank you for that. And I just ask that you will bless us and that you will bless our families this week as we begin celebrating the holiday season and for Thanksgiving and for all the things that we're thankful for. And Lord, most importantly, we're thankful for you and the fact that you sent your son for us to die on the cross for our sins. And Lord, I thank you for each of these children. In Jesus' name, amen.
Boys and girls, one other little thing. You know who this is hardest on? This kid. And she needs a group hug from you before she leaves here. And every time you see her, you just grab her and hug her and say, would you do that? Give her a group hug? Get down here where they can get to you.